August 1st, 2012. As a passenger jet travels above the Pacific Ocean, almost 500 miles from the New Zealand coast, the pilot spots something in the water below him.
The pilot looks out the window and sees what looks like a giant island in the South Pacific.
The Pacific holds around 25,000 islands. The plane is nowhere near any of them.
This is supposed to be open ocean. There shouldn't be anything visible other than water for hundreds of miles.
Investigators immediately consult scans of the area taken by NASA's Terra satellite. Recent images confirm their suspicion. Something has materialized in the middle of nowhere.
Whatever it is they found was not there before. It just appeared out of nowhere.
Where would it have come from? What actually are we looking at?
Whatever the thing is, however it appeared, it's more than 200 miles long.
The scale of this is enormous. This is the size of a small country.
When analysts compare the coordinates of the pilot's sighting with the latest satellite image, they discover something disturbing.
This object appears to be moving, and islands don't move.
The anomaly moves relentlessly towards land. The pressure to work out what it is and where it came from builds.
Like all geologic investigations, it really comes down to getting a sample to analyze. Someone really needs to get a piece of this material.
On August 9th, a full week after the initial sighting, the New Zealand Navy dispatches a ship to study the strange phenomenon.
The ship goes to investigate, and what they find is something that's 300 miles long by 30 miles wide, and the captain reports that it's the strangest thing he's ever seen.
It's a unique and bizarre thing to witness, and it looks like mud or some kind of dirt, this skin, this mass of rock just floating on the surface of the water.
The concept of a giant mass of rocks moving across the ocean seems to defy the laws of physics. But the Navy's examination of the sample proves that's exactly what it is. The weird stones are pumice, a type of lightweight rock formed when undersea volcanoes eject lava into the water.
When pumice is formed, the volcanic eruption injects a lot of gas bubbles into the lava, and they get trapped inside the rock, becomes buoyant, and floats to the surface.
The giant anomaly is in fact billions and billions of individual pumice stones floating across the ocean like a country-sized raft.
If there's enough pumice all gathered in one spot, it can look like a solid island, but it's not.